So in lesson one, you used the ping tool to test connectivity between your machine and another network host. But what's ping actually doing? There's a tool you can use to display quite a bit of detail about network traffic between hosts and networks. It's called tcpdump, and it's slightly misnamed. It can actually look at any network traffic, not just TCP. You already installed it on your machine back in lesson one, so let's take a look at the manual for it. Oh, holy wow, that's a lot of options. Okay, we're going to ignore most of these. The important part is that we need to tell tcpdump what traffic we want. It has its own little language for this, called the PCAP filter syntax. You can look at the PCAP-filter man page for more about it. But for now, I'll just give you a really straightforward command to catch traffic that's going between your host and the host at 8.8.8.8. So it's going to be sudo tcpdump -n host 8.8.8.8. Now let's run tcpdump over here and run ping again over here. Oh hey, look, packets. Now for each ping over here, which there are three, we see two packet records over here. Two messages appear from tcpdump, one after the other. Each one of these records is a description of one of the packets that ping is sending over to that machine, or one that's coming back. See, here's 8.8.8.8, and here's the IP address of my machine. And here it says that this record is an ICMP echo request, that's a ping request, and then coming back is an echo reply. Echo request is the message that ping sends, and echo reply is the one coming back. Other things agree too. For instance, the ping program tells us that it got 64 bytes, and sure enough, there's length 64. To exit tcpdump, we'll type Control-C. You can use tcpdump to monitor traffic for any network application. Like for instance, if you wanted to see all the DNS requests your machine sends, you'd need to know what port DNS uses, which is port 53, by the way. And then you'd compose a line like this, sudo tcpdump -n port 53. Then if you do anything that causes a DNS lookup, like say pinging a machine by hostname, you'd see the DNS traffic, like so. If you look closely, here's my IP address, and here's the IP address of the DNS server that I'm using. And since I pinged yahoo.com, here's an A query, or A request, question mark for query, for yahoo.com. And then here comes back the response on the next line, with an A response, the first IP address in it being 206.190.36.45, which is the IP address that ping is using to ping Yahoo. Take a moment to try this yourself. Don't worry about all the other bits the tcpdump prints out, but do get a sense of where the traffic you're looking at is coming from and going to.